UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Basically, a table. A table in the HTML page will be looks like this. Say for example, this is our table. So this row, this is called as row, right? These are called as rows, right? This is the row. Okay, this is a row. So a table will be represented HTML. In terms of HTML, it may contain some T body, and then table row. Okay, here in table row it will contain some table data. A table will represent like this. Okay, then end of T body and end of table like this. Okay, HTML table will looks like this. Here TR means table row. This one. Okay, see here I have mentioned table data, right? This I can say it's a cell. So it is like this. Okay, this is a table row. So it is like, this is a table data. Okay, this is a table data. In the sense, this is like a cell. Okay, now these are all table data and each one is a row here, table row. Okay, now we'll go with an application here. Yeah, see here, this is a table. Okay. Now how can I conclude whether it is a table or not? Right click out here and say inspect element with firebug. Okay. Now everyone observe. Can you all agree here? I said table. If you all agree here, if I keep my cursor over here, can you observe that? If I keep my cursor over here, it is a table and table body. Okay, table row. If I keep my cursor on this one, the first row is getting highlighted. If I keep my cursor over here, the second row is getting highlighted. Third row is getting highlighted. Fourth row. Fifth row. Can you all observe it? Again here in the table row, again, you can see a table data. Okay, if I keep it on it, that bank, this particular cell is getting highlighted. If I keep my cursor on this, interest rate is getting highlighted. Okay, apply. Now similarly, if you go somewhere this one, so if you keep your cursor over here, this particular section is getting highlighted. Okay. So in HTML, a table will be represented like this: table, table body, table row, table row contains the table data. So here, basically here in our Selenium, which kind of scenarios you will come across means it's not only Selenium. Basically, in automation, generally we may come across scenarios like, say, I will pass this HDFC limited. Okay, based on that, we have to click on apply. Okay, so now what we have to do? First of all, we have to identify this cell. First of all, we have to identify this cell. Based on this cell, we have to identify this. Okay, so that is where we are going to write a bit more complex exports. Okay, so here in this case, we have to write a complex exports. Now see here, let us try to write a export for this. Now everyone close up here. Say what I'm saying here, say for example, based on this ICICI Bank, okay, or based on this HDFC Limited, say I want to click on this apply based on this HDFC Limited. How can I recognize HDFC? First of all, we have to recognize this HDFC Limited. Okay. First, we have to recognize this HDFC Limited. Based on this HDFC Limited, we have to click on this. However, before that, how can I recognize this HDFC Limited? Any guesses? How to recognize this HDFC Limited? It's normal way. This is going to be normal way. It's like we have discussed the some formulas right here. We have discussed some formulas right. Yep. First use those formulas. Okay. Probably you can use this property or this one. First we'll try with the first one. We'll see whether it is helpful or not. Okay. So now everyone agree here. First, I'm saying identify this. So identify by probably even it is a link. See here, even you can take this link. Everyone agree here. But here basically, our intention was not to identify this. Our intention is to identify this. So based on this, we have to identify this, right? So that is where this direct locator will not be helpful. First of all, we have to identify this HDFC Limited by using export. Now see here, I took the first locator, the first formula here. So what is the HTML tag? What is the HTML tag of this object? Here, A. Okay. See here. And then here, okay, class, probably this table text, here also we have table text, here also table text. It means class is the property which may not helpful for us. Style is a general thing, color is a general thing, text direction is also same thing. The only property that would be helpful for us is href property here, href property and its value here. And moreover here, if you all agree here, this is this property is a longer property. I mean, value is a bigger one. So even if we don't need to use this much, see here in this case, let me go with the second one. Why? Because here we don't need to mention the complete value here. It is saying just contains. Contains means you can mention a part of it. So let me go with the second one. HTML tag is A, contains, and what is the property name? href is the property name, and the property value here, this one, home loan, right? See here, I'm not taking the complete one, I'm just taking this HDFC, this one, even I can take this only. Okay, as why I am just taking part of it? Because here they are using contents. Here it is highlighting something else, it seems. It is highlighting somewhere here. I think it is highlighting this HDFC limited. Can you all agree? It is highlighting something else. So any guesses? How can we fix it? Here, now see here, as I'm trying to highlight, it is highlighting something else here. It is highlighting this particular section, this HDFC limited. But here we wanted to highlight this HDFC limited. So now see here, as this is not going to work out, I'm just going with its parent. Okay, now I'm trying with its parent. So I'm saying slash table data. So let us try to highlight. Now can you all agree? Okay. Yesterday's session, I think someone was asking this question. Okay, if there are two objects, how can we differentiate one object to the other object? So this is the answer. See here, we have HDFC limited here and here, and as we are using, previously it was highlighting this. Now I was trying to differentiate using its parent object. Okay, even its parent object is also same. Say even here it looks like a table data, right? Say here also it is in the table. In that case, again we would have go with the next parent. Okay, as of now I took immediate parent. Say this immediate parent is also not helping, again we can go with the its parent here. Now everyone up here, as of now what I have done, I'm able to recognize this HDFC limited here. Okay, but our intention is to click on this apply, right? Our intention is to click on this apply. Okay, our intention is to click on the supply, but I can just recognize that particular HDFC limited. Now everyone observe here, it is just highlighting this, now we are able to highlight this particular portion only. Okay, even not that cell, there is a difference. Everyone observe here, when I keep my cursor over here, everyone observe here, if I keep my cursor here, it is highlighting that HDFC limited only. If I keep my cursor on this table data, it is highlighting that particular cell. So what I'm trying to explain here, let me show what's happening here. Now again here in table data, here I said we'll have a table row, and we'll have a table data, right? Again in this table data, there is a link, okay? Part of this table data, again we have a link here. Okay, now whatever the logic that we have written, it is identifying this only. Everyone try to understand whatever the logic, whatever we have written, that is just identifying this one only. Okay, see here a link, it is like HDFC limited, right? It is just highlighting this only. It is not highlighting this one, it is highlighting this only. But basically we want to click something in this cell. Now actually if you close the up here, what we have to do, we have to click on the supply. Now everyone spy this. See here, even it seems it is an image, that apply is an image, and it is a part of a link. Again this link is a part of table data. Can you all agree here? Now basically here, this is where a bit a complex one. Everyone agree here? Under this table data we have a link. It's showing a link. Okay, under this link we have an image. Basically our intention is to click on this image. Based on what? Our intention is to click on this image. Based on this HDFC limited. Now we are successfully identifying this HDFC limited here. Now, how can I recognize this image based on this? First of all, are you able to, is it clear? The HTML structure is that clear? Of course, just forget about how to write it. First of all, did you understand the HTML structure of this, this scenario here? Here, we are able to identify this. But basically, we want to click on this image. And this image is a part of link. Link is a part of this table data. Any questions on the structure here? If you understand the next part only, you will understand. That is the reason I am asking here. Any questions here? If any questions, let me know. Yep. So now we are successfully identifying this. So based on this, we have to identify this, right? So how to identify means, first from based on this, we have to identify its parent. Okay. From this HDFC Limited, first of all, we have to identify this parent. And after identifying first step is, identify the parent. Okay. Second step is identify the respective cell. I mean to say here, from this first we have to identify this one. Okay, identify the parent means from this we have to identify this. And from this table data, we have to identify this particular cell. I mean, identify the respective another table data. And from here, we can identify this. The third step is, from the respective cell, I can say instead of respective, intended cell. Let me say, intended. I mean, we want to identify that particular cell, right? So from the intended cell, identify the required object. Okay. Now everyone observe. So now we are again before this. I can say like first identify object. So first of all we have done this. Now we are successful in completing first step. So now we have identified this object. Now our next step is identify the parent. Now how to identify the parent means, now everyone observe here. So from this we are able to identify that HDFC Limited. From that we want to identify its parent. Now here there is something called ancestor. Ancestor can you all agree? I've used something called ancestor table data. Okay. Now everyone agree here. First of all we have used this logic. First of all we wrote this logic. So as part of this first step. Okay. Give me a minute. As part of this first step, we have used this one, okay. And as part of the second step, I mean, identify the parent, we have used this, okay. You want me to write? I think it is better to write here itself. Now I have used this ancestor of KD, okay. So now here I am successful in identifying its parent here. Can you all agree here? There is a difference, right? Otherwise, let me do one thing. Here itself I can let us maintain the different locators so that we can see the difference here. The first one was just highlighting the text only. Okay. The second one is highlighting the cell. There is a difference. Okay. Now basically our intention is based on this cell we have to identify this cell. Okay. For that now see here. Now here there is something called following sibling. Okay. There is something called following sibling. you all observed? And if you observe here, I said following sibling and sibling in a sense, what is this? Currently we identified a table data. Technically we identified table data. Sibling means again we have to identify table data, right? And from this HDFC Limited to this one, how many cells are there? 1 and 2, right? So that is the reason I said table data of 2. For example, if I mention table data of 1, everyone observe here. If I mention table data of 1, here it is held in the next one. Okay. Now see here, I am saying table data 2. Now let us say this one. Okay. Now we are successfully identifying this particular cell. Now but what actually we wanted to do here? Now this third step is done. We identified the intended cell. We identified it. And from the identified cell, identify the required object. So here actually we want to click on the supply, right? So now observe here. Now from this cell within this cell only we have what we have, this one only, right? So we are able to identify this cell now. Now in this cell first we have A type and then we have image time. Now simply we can say, everyone observe here, you can say A slash IMG. Now see here, can you all observe it? If you all observe, it is getting highlighted, it is highlighting the apply button against the HDFC Limited. Can you all observe it? Okay, now this is the final locator. So this is one of the complex locator. Like if you are able to write these kind of locators, you are expert in exports. Okay. Any questions on this? Okay. Now here, see here. First of all, I'm trying to again identify this one. First of all, I am trying to identify this SQQ. So for that, here I am using a general formula here. I mean formula here, this one. I am trying to use this formula here. We will see whether we can able to write it or not. So again here, as per the formula, HTML tag is A. Okay. And here property name. Here in this contains property name here, of course you can use href, or even now we will give a try with other one. So everyone observe here, I am using just a simply dot here. Okay, and here everyone observe here, in this single quotation I am saying S triple Q. We will try to find it out. Can you all observe it? It means here I mentioned a dot. It means it can be anything. So I'm simply trying to identify this this particular text. Or there is one more option here. We can use text. Here again, text is a function again. I'm using a function in a function. Now can you all observe here? But here, if you all observe here, in this properties here, we don't have any text, right? If you all observe here, we don't have any text. But still, it is recognizing. As I said, text is a, again part of the export. Text is a function here. It's not a property here in this case. Okay. We can use text. We can use dot as we don't have any direct way here. Okay. So text means we are saying that we have a link whose text is this one. Okay. Now, however, we are identified this as triple Q. Now, what is the next step? What I have to do here now? What I have to do? Can anyone of you guide me? Now I successfully identified that particular S triple Q. Now what I have to do? What is the next step? That's correct, Nashin. So we are able to successfully identify this, right? Now we have to identify its parent. So how I can identify? So slash, I have to say ancestor, and what is the type of its parent? Table data, right? So yeah, just fine. Now if you all observe here, it is highlighting that parent. Now basically from this we want to identify this particular cell, right? Now here again I have to say preceding sibling. Okay, previously I was saying following sibling, now I am saying preceding sibling. And what is the type of the sibling? Table data. Now let me say fine. Can you all agree here? Now if you have, now again you may ask one question. Here I simply mentioned table data, I did not mention 1, 2, 3, because here before that we have only one, so I don't need to mention 1 or 2. Even one is, I think one is also, it is going to work. Can you all agree here? As we have only one, either you mention or you don't mention, it's not going to be matter. Okay, so now if you all agree here, I have used something called preceding sibling here. Okay, this is one more thing probably you may come across. Basically I can say it's a very rare case, I generally never come across preceding one. But however, if you suddenly come across, you had already written here. Okay. Now I have identified that particular cell. Again, within that cell, say I want to identify this link. What I have to do now? I want to identify that link. What I have to do? Say it seems it is link, right? You spy this. Say it's a link. Right? It's a link within that cell. Now what I have to do? Say I don't want to identify this cell, I want to identify that link. Or based on this text, I want to click on this link. Now what is the next step? Any guesses? What I have to do now? Now we are successfully identifying that particular cell, right? Within that cell we have that text, that link. Now what I have to do? What happened? Any confusion? Are you able to follow this? Say I am saying we are successfully identifying this cell. But again within this cell we have a link. Say now in this case I want to click on this link. Now how can I write this? That is what we have discussed earlier, right? Here I was using this one, right? Once I identified the cell, I said /a/img, right? Now here this link is a part of this cell. Now we are successfully identifying this table data. Now see here, now we can use this slash a, right? So here we can simply use slash a so that it is going to recognize that particular link. Now can you all observe it? It is just highlighting that link. Previously it was highlighting that particular cell. Okay. So this is how we can use preceding sibling. So these are the complex exploits. Okay, generally complex exploits comes into picture when we have tables. Okay, if you can write these complex exploits, you are going to write any kind of logic. Okay. Now what is the use of find element? What is the purpose of find element? Why we are using in our scripts, why we are using this find elements? To recognize the objects, right? In other words, if you remember I used to highlight like this, and I used to say, no, this is going to highlight the this is going to recognize the object, and after that it is going to clear, right? So basically find element is a method. Find element is a method which help us to recognize the object. Okay, so it is here it is going to recognize a particular object. It is going to recognize a particular object. Say if I say here in this case O browser find element this JH-AC, it is going to recognize a text box. It seems it is a AVI application here. Okay, so it seems it is representing this particular text box. when I use find element of this locator, okay, it will recognize this particular text box. Okay, when I say O browser find element this J-AC. Okay, now see here. J-AC. So it is going to recognize this particular text box. That is the use of find element, right? Now similarly, there is something called find elements. There is a simple difference. Can you all observe it? There is a small difference. Previously it was identifying only one object. Now there is something called find elements. Okay. Find elements means it is going to recognize the set of objects. I mean to say group of objects. So find elements is a method which will identify some set of objects. Okay. So when to use a find elements? What is the purpose? Why should we go for find elements? We have find element which is going to recognize a particular object and we can perform our required operation. Then what is the purpose of this find elements? Here, whenever you come across any scenario like wherever if you want to retrieve some set of objects, okay, you can use find elements. One of the best example here, say you have searched for some product here. Here I'm searching for camera here. Okay, here, see here, everyone observe here. I would like to find these prices. I want to find these prices. I want to find all the prices of these results here. I mean, if you observe here, it is showing some prices, right? I want to collect, I want to find out all the prices, all the results prices here, these prices. Okay, I want to find all these prices. I want to collect, I want to know what are the prices. Okay, so here it's a collective objects. It's a set of objects that we want to refer here. Okay. This is one of the interview question I used to ask in any interview. It might be QTP interview, it might be Selenium interview. I used to ask this question. It will not be direct concept. Okay, I used to ask like this. You know, say you have opened some shopping website and say you want to purchase one item and you are searching for that particular item and you got some set of results. Okay, among the results I want to find out all the prices. Again from that prices I want to find the least price. Okay, this is a general question I used to ask. It might be a QTP, it might be a Selenium interview. Okay, so for that you have to answer this. Okay, basically you have to use this find elements. Okay, by using find elements I can recognize this set of objects. Okay, so basically the small difference between find element and find elements is in find element we are going to give a unique description so that the object is going to be recognized uniquely. Okay, in find elements we will give a generic locator so that it is going to collect a set of objects with the same properties. So here in this case we wanted to identify these prices, right? We want to retrieve all these prices. Now everyone observe here, I'm spying this particular first price. Now everyone observe here, it has some class, okay, and even it has some other class LV price PRC. We'll just make a note of this. Okay, see here I'm just making a note of this. Okay, now see here I have GB and even I'm just making a note of this also. Okay, we'll see which properties are common for these objects here. So first of all, as of now, what I've done, I spied but this particular object, okay, and here I took this property and I took this property. Okay, just I just make a note of this. Okay, now here we'll scroll down. Now we'll try to spy this object. Okay, see here I spied this object. And again here it has this section. when we use this section, when we use this section, it's going to highlight this particular section. I mean, it is going to retrieve these values, and it is also going to retrieve this last price too. Okay. However, we'll see. We'll observe. And here we have span this particular object. I'm just trying to find the common properties for these objects. Okay. Now let us spy somewhere some object here. Okay. We'll spy this object. Okay. I spy the other object here. I'm just randomly spraying it, okay, and then see here. So it seems there are some set of common properties. Can you all observe here? Probably, if you want to find out these prices, probably we can use class F this G-B. Okay, can you all agree here? We can use this G-B as class property so that it may retrieve all the set of properties here. But if this class is being used for other objects also, it is going to retrieve those. Okay, well, first of all, we'll write a logic here. Now see here, I hope everyone is able to write the logics right. I'll forget this. Okay, once this completes, I will come back to that. First of all, I am opening the Firefox browser, so then we'll open ebay.com. Okay. Once you open ebay.com, you have to enter some camera here, right? You have to enter something here in this text box. Okay, it has some ID. Okay, so our browser dot first of all we have to identify it, right? So identify by ID. So first of all we are identifying, we are clearing it if we have, if it has any text. We are clearing it, then we are going to send, we are going to enter values. Here let me say camera. Okay, after that we have to click on this search button. So I'm spying this, so it has ID. So our browser, find element by ID. We are going to click on it. Okay. So once you click on it, you will get into this page. Okay. Now here we can find a common property like this one G-B. Now we try to everyone observe. Till this point we know these things, right? Till this point we know how to write logic. Now here, O browser, find element. Okay. Here find elements. Now everyone observe. There is a find element, find elements. Okay. Now here it is going to give list of web elements. Now if you observe what it is going to give an output. By using this line, it is going to give list of web elements. So I'm saying list of web elements. Okay. And here by class we are trying to recognize it. There is something called by class name. What is the class name here? What was that? G-B, right? This is the class property. So I'm using this by class property. We are trying to write the logic here. Okay. G-B. Okay. And basically it is going to retrieve. It is going to give list of web elements, right? I'm saying here. I used to forget because it's a very rare case. It's here. It is going to give this output, list of web elements. So now I have to capture into an array kind of. So list web element. Okay. Yeah, let me say UI prices. So this UI prices is a kind of array. Array in the sense it is going to contain list of prices, list of all the prices. So what is the type means? It's a list. Okay. Here we have to retrieve this util. And here web element. Again it is related to Selenium. So I'm retrieved the retrieve things. Now this UI prices is going to contain the all the prices here. Okay. So here I'm writing a for loop. Okay. I think we already did we come across this kind of logic? I don't think so. Now see here, this is the we understand for loops, right? In as part of Java somewhere we discussed the for loop. Now whatever the for loop now I'm going to write, it's a bit different. Okay. In general what we have written for int I equal to 1, I less than or equal to I less than 10, and then I plus plus, right? So this is how we have written a for loop. Now what are the for loop now I'm going to write? It's a bit different. So for loop. Now let me complete, then let me explain. Okay. Now here let me say UI single Now everyone observe here. Now I said this is the web elements. It is a list of web elements. It is like an array. It means it is going to contain all the prices. Okay. Now here I am writing a for loop. And if you observe here, this is a variable here. UI single price. UI single price is a variable. What is the type of this variable? Any guesses? What is the type of this variable? Any guesses here? The type of this variable is web element. Okay. Now here this UI prices is a list of web elements. So if I want to refer this list of web elements, I'm just creating a variable of type web element. Okay. Here this is a UI single price is a web it's a variable of type web element, and I mentioned something like this colon with this this one. So what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of the highlighted one means? This for loop is going to repeat it for the number of times that are there in the, it is going to be repeated based on the number of items here in this list. Okay. Say if you have 20 prices, say if you have 20 prices in this list, this for loop is going to be iterated for, it is going to be repeated for 20 times. Okay. And for each time, for each iteration, for each repetition, this variable value is going to refer one value. It is something like this. Say for example, say we have these are the prices. Okay. Say these are the, say just assume these are the different prices that are there in that variable. Okay. So here it has around 7 values. Okay. So say this variable contain, say this variable contain these 7 prices. Assume it contains 7 prices. Okay. That for loop is going to be iterated for 7 times. And each time this variable is there, right? Your single price. For each iteration, whose value changes? For the first iteration, this I value is going to be represent this. Okay, this value is going to be represent this. Okay, for the second iteration, it's going to refer this one. Okay, this variable is going to represent this. Okay. Similarly, say for the fifth iteration, it is going to represent this. Okay, whose value varies from iteration to iteration. Okay, now whatever the logic that I have written means, so this for loop is going to repeat it based on the number of items here, and for each iteration, this value changes from one value to the other value. So here as we know that now this variable is going to represent that particular value in that list box. For each iteration, whose value changes from one value to the other value. So I said simply getText. GetText is a method which is going to retrieve the text and it is going to be print. It is going to retrieve the text. Now see here I'm using system dot out dot println. I'm trying to print this. Everyone up there. So each time this variable is going to represent one particular price, and I'm getting the text of it. Get text means it is retrieves the text of that particular value, and I'm printing it. Okay. Now I will try to execute it. How can I execute this? How to execute this one? Now we'll try to execute this. Let it execute. Meanwhile, I have a question. I hope every one of you has been practicing, right? If anyone is not practicing, please practice. Please try to write the scripts from your end. And is there anyone who don't have the confidence in writing this Selenium scripts, at least the basics? Like, can you write the logic like at least this one? At least till this. Is there anyone who don't have the confidence in writing this logic? Please let me know. No, if you have any, okay, Olga, you are there, okay. Then why don't you come up and why you are not asking the questions? Yep, we'll discuss, Olga. Yep, let me complete this and we'll come back to your thing. And is there anyone? Here I can see one of our friends. Is there anyone who don't have the confidence in writing at least these things? Because going forward, from the next class onwards, we are going to we are going to discuss a bit more advanced. Okay, these are the like whatever we have been discussing. It's like these are like medium level of complex things. Okay, the next things will be a bit of complex. Can you all observe in the background? Can you all observe the background? It is printing the prices here. It seems that class, whatever the class that we have chosen, can you all observe here in the background here? It took the prices here. Okay. But it seems, this it is showing this last price and this buy it now, right? It seems
they have used, I mean the developer has used that property, this property, this where is that, this one, this g-b, even for this some set of the text. Okay, I mean to say here, if you see here 870, right, probably we will go here where we have this 870. I don't find 870 here. Okay, the search might be different from here to here. Now it is showing a bit differently. Okay. Search for 870 here. Yep, here. Can you all agree here? Basically this 870 is being printed here, I mean this here last page is also printed along with 870 here. So it seems, you know, developer has used that property g-b even for this 870 here. Just showing last page only, right? Here for this 870 and for this last price, we don't have the this property, right? G-B. G-B is there here, but here we don't have this. Why it is printing there? Are you getting my question here? I mean, did you understand the problem here? Basically, it is printing this last price and this buy it now. And if you close the observer here, basically those don't have the this G-B property here. Okay. These two does not have the G-B property. Actually, I am trying in this web driver thing. That is the reason a bit of kind of confusion. Let me go here. Try to supply this. Actually, even it is retrieving its sibling values, it seems. Can you all agree here? Here we have this class B. Okay. Even it is retrieving its sibling's value. Okay. So, actually, here, but the concept is will be the same thing. Okay. So if you all agree here, it just retrieved all the prices here. Okay, it retrieved all the prices here. Of course, probably maybe we can tune and we can take a very good property here instead of this class name. Maybe we can take other property. I don't think so. We have other properties, right? Probably we can take exports. Not even exports. Are you getting what I'm saying here? Basically, it is retrieving this what we say, the sibling's value also. Actually, it has to retrieve this value only. Okay. When I say G-B, it is just it has to retrieve this value only. It is retrieving the sibling's value also. This is how the concept will looks like. Okay, let's simply use find elements. and probably here maybe we need to tune it out. Okay, here here this can be tuned out. Okay, this we can tune it out. Okay, basically whatever the class name that we are using, it is retrieving these properties. Okay, even we can use the exports here. Again, we have to build it. Again, we have to see what is the comma export for all these objects. Okay, how these objects has been placed, and we have to analyze, and we have to accordingly we have to take the exports. Okay.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.